achieve that. But we're also getting shortlisted for a number of other awards, entrepreneurialism, efficiency, and economic, driving economic growth. So across the piece, you know, there's a good, we've got a good story to tell on our corporate health. So I'm delighted to present this report to council, to cabinet, and the report is for endorsement. Okay. Chair.
Thank you, Anne. I would again echo and endorse the very positive comments that you made about the report. I'd just like to take this opportunity of thanking you as a portfolio member for governments for the excellent work that you've done throughout the year to make sure that we have those very high standards now. And as you say, to move from kind of 15 areas down to four areas is a tremendous achievement in the last 3 years. So thanks, Sam, to the work that you've done. Thanks to the officers as well that have worked with you. And I'd just like to invite Cabinet, can we endorse this annual government statement 14-15? Agreed. Thank you very much. Okay, I think that takes us to the final item on our agenda tonight, under Neighbourhoods Housing Engagement. That's item 7, empowering locally neighbourhood working to deliver the Rural Plan 2020. George.
Thanks, Phil. Right, one of the key principles of the Rural Plan 2020 is empowering locally, giving back power and responsibility to communities and tailoring public services to meet the unique needs of local areas and neighbourhoods. This report highlights the need to further develop the council's approach to neighbourhood working in order to deliver Wirral's Plan 2020 outcomes at a local level. It is proposed to develop a 3-year neighbourhood working development plan and delivery plan by December 2015 with key partners that will include how constituencies can influence more integrated public services in their local areas, looking beyond our organisational boundaries within public, voluntary and private sectors. How constituencies can promote and encourage more independent and responsible citizens and communities. How resources need to be pooled and shared, and how we need to make the best use of assets for the benefit of our local people. How constituency neighbourhood plans need to be linked to the Wirral Plan 2020 outcomes. The constituency teams will lead on work streams as part of developing the plans, including A, operational integration, B, process planning, example constituency stroke neighbourhood plans, asset transfers, etc. C, aligning resources, and D, community development models. Cabinet therefore are asked to agree a set of the further develops of neighbourhood working via a neighbourhood working development plan and delivery plan. Promotion of co-location of staff and partners working across organisational boundaries. The realignment of resources required to deliver the right neighbourhood working models for Wirral. And the review of the role of consistency committees and consistency managers in line with the right neighbourhood working model. Can I just add to that as well, Chair, because I think it's very much important. I fully endorse this as a way forward. But what I will have to stress as well, and that goes to the officers as well, is that whatever we do here, based on the way the council finances at this present moment in time, will have to be done, as I understand it, within existing resources. And therefore, if the part on the back, which is the neighbourhood city influence model phase one and phase two and B. There's a part there which basically says require additional resources, admin support, and public development. So one of the things that I would say at the present moment in time, I agree with the whole report, but I couldn't move at this moment additional resources, because as far as I'm aware, if we work within and with our partners to make that happen, I think we'll get the full support whatsoever of cabinet. But I think by just saying and adding resources in, I don't think we can actually support that part. But the
the other plan, the best of that plan to me is exactly where the needs to go, and I support that 100%. Match the camp, I suppose, with that recommendation on the end about the
Okay, thanks, Stuart. Yeah, I mean, I think that last point is really important because I think, you know, going back to the discussion we had around the 2020 plan, we've got to work smarter within existing resources. And the Travel 2020 plan has absolutely, you know, hit the nail on the head. This is as much about working differently as about the kind of outcomes. The outcomes are important, but to achieve the outcomes, we need to work differently and more creatively and innovatively. Because we simply won't have the resources to do everything in a way that we do at the moment. But I do, George, agree with you that a lot of the information in this report is, I think, very much in line with the asset-based community development model that many of us have studied and seen in action elsewhere. You know, and I think you're absolutely right, George. There is huge talent in our communities that we need to release to help us achieve a lot of our pledges and our goals over the next 5 years. And if we can move to that model rather than the council or somebody else does everything for people, which we won't have the resources to do, I think if we can move to a model where we're encouraging people who've got those skills, talents and energies to use them for the benefit of their communities and their neighbourhoods. And that's exactly, I think, the change in culture, I think you used the expression early, changing behaviour that we need to promote. So absolutely, I think that ethos, that philosophy is spot on. Okay, so can I ask members to turn to the recommendations in paragraph 13, that George moved. Can you agree those recommendations? Okay, thank you very much. Right, I've not been notified of any other urgent business, so that brings us to the end of this meeting of the Cabinet. I'll close the meeting, and can I thank you for your attendance. Thank you. Thank you.